Hi everyone, this is Nick. I got a quick viewer question over on our video about how to align and distribute objects on a PowerPoint slide. The question is down here, and they say that, hi thanks, what if the images are in several rows? Please, what's the fastest way to do them all at once instead of aligning row by row? I think you have to do this row by row, unfortunately, if you have several objects on a slide like this or text boxes, but there are some pretty quick ways that you can go ahead and do this. So the one thing that we know from a previous video is you don't have to click one object, push the shift key, and then continue to click all the ones that you wish to align. In PowerPoint, everything is on a blank canvas. You can click and drag across the canvas, and anything within that gray highlighted box will be selected just like this. Now we know that we can go up to the Arrange tools, go to Align, and we can click on Center, and now those will be nice and centered. But if you don't want to do all those clicks, I suggest adding the Alignment tools and the Distribution tools to your Quick Access toolbar. The Quick Access toolbar are all these little buttons right down here, and in order to access that to add things to the Quick Access toolbar, the QAT, all you need to do is go to that tool in the home, in whatever tab or ribbon that you have in PowerPoint, and then right here on Alignment, I'm going to go ahead and right click, and you will see the option that says Add to Quick Access Toolbar. Right now, my option to add it has been grayed out because I've already added it to my Quick Access Toolbar. If I wanted to hide the Quick Access Toolbar, I could do that by clicking here. If I wanted to customize the ribbon or collapse the ribbon, I could do that here as well. So go ahead and add those to your Quick Access Toolbar, to your QAT, and then once you do that, you'll see them right up here. And now all you have to do is drag your mouse just a little bit and go right to that menu instead of clicking through the tab menus. So right now we have our circle centered. I'm gonna go ahead and just drag all of this here. I'm gonna go ahead and center these with Alignment. I'm just gonna go ahead and center. Oops, that was right. Center. See, it does get tedious if you have a whole bunch of things, but it's kind of quick. So now we want to do the rows. So let's go ahead and make sure that the rows are all centered. I'm going to actually do these to the middle. Middle. Make sure all of these are in the middle. After we do this, we're gonna have to distribute them. So I'm just making sure all of these are in the middle here. Nice and quick. We're aligning these to the middle. Now what we need to do is distribute everything. So what I'm gonna do is actually, I'm gonna group everything in rows. Here, I'm gonna group those. I'm gonna group these. And we're just pushing Control G to group everything as if they were one object. Nice. And now what I'm gonna do is hold down shift and click all of these. We're gonna go back to our distribute tools right here, say distribute horizontally, and now they've distributed perfectly horizontally. Now I'm gonna ungroup everything at once by shift control G, push shift control G, perfect. And now I'm gonna group the rows together. Control G to group, control G to group, control G to group, control G to group, and control G to group. Hold down shift, select all of the rows, and now let's distribute them vertically right here. Perfect. Now we have a beautifully spaced table. If I wanted to ungroup them, I could do shift control G again, and now they're all individual objects, but they're all still perfectly spaced and perfectly distributed. And this video only took 3 minutes, and I think that clicking took about a minute to a minute and a half. So I hope this helps. There wasn't a really quick fix way to just take every single object on the slide and distribute them perfectly all at once, especially if you don't have, especially if they're not the same object. There is one little trick that I might want to show you here as kind of a bonus trick. I'm going to go ahead and insert a square. If for some reason you want to have a whole bunch of the same shape in perfectly distributed rows and columns, say I wanted to have a whole bunch of squares, maybe 100 different squares in this space, all you need to do is draw one shape, go up to your Bright Slide tab. If you don't have the Bright Slide tab, that's because you haven't downloaded the free PowerPoint add-in called Bright Slide. I'll link to that above and below. Make sure to go and download this. This is a really cool tip. If I want this square to turn into 100 tiny little miniature miniature squares perfectly spaced in rows and columns. We'll just go up to the bright side tab right here. We'll go to the repeat and distribute button right here. We'll click on that. It will ask us how many rows and columns do we want. I have 10 rows, 10 columns, perfect little squares. Push OK. If you wanted others, if you wanted something else, maybe you just want 5 rows and 5 columns, we could do that. And that would be perfect. I would push OK. If I wanted more space between them, I could adjust the gutter space. If I wanted to adjust the width and the height, I could do that as well. I'm going to click OK. That is a really cool tip if you have the same shape that you want to evenly distribute across a PowerPoint and do little tiny miniatures like this. A great way to make a waffle chart or something like that as well. So if you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I can't wait to see you all next time.